Once there was a boy named Todu who lived in the grass country north of Kumasi in Ashanti. He had to care for his father's cattle, and day after day he took them to the watering places and watched them graze. His father's herd had many cows and only one bull, but it was the largest bull in all Africa. Its name was Only One. Whenever a bull calf was born, Only One would kill it, for he thought one bull was enough for his herd. One time a bull calf was born, and Todu liked him very much. Only One didn't know about the calf yet, so Todu carried him away into the bush country and hid him. Every day he crept back to the herd to get milk for the calf from its mother. The old bull, Only One, was getting suspicious about things, so when the calf was a little bigger, Todu took him far into the back country. The calf grew up. When he was 4 years old, he was almost as big as Only One. Then Todu took him to a great rock that lay in the middle of the plains and said, "You look like a bull, and you act like a bull, but you aren't full grown until you're strong enough to move this rock." The bull put his head down and pushed against the great rock, but nothing happened. "You're too young. You're still a calf," Todu said. "Wait another year." The young bull was so provoked because he couldn't move the rock that he pawed the ground with his foot. He pawed so deep and wide that a lake came up, and that was Lake Burro. The next year, the boy took his bull to the rock again and said, "Put your horns to it and try again." The young bull put his head down and tried to toss the great rock, but it didn't budge. "You're too young yet," Todu said. "You're not grown up." The bull was so angry, he put one horn in the ground and charged through the bush, plowing a deep furrow. He plowed so deep and far that water came up and began to flow, and that was the Adifofu River. They waited another year, and again Todu said, "You're bigger now. Put your horns to the rock and push it." The bull put his head down, and he pushed so hard his eyes got red and white foam came out on his hide, but the rock didn't move. He was so angry that he ran into the forest, tearing down all the trees for miles around. This was the great hurricane that Ashanti people still talk about. Another year came, and the boy said to his bull, "Try again." This time the bull dug his feet in, and his muscles bulged, and the rock swayed a little. "Next year you'll do it," Todu said. But the bull was unhappy. He bellowed, and down in Kumasi it sounded like thunder, and the people ran for shelter. The next year the bull was 8 years old, and his horns were as thick as the trunk of a baobab tree. "Try it again," Todu said. The bull tried the rock gently with his horns. Then he went a mile away across the flat grasslands. He pawed the ground, and then he began to run. He charged across the plains with his head down low and struck the great rock in the middle. It smashed into many pieces and flew into the air in all directions. Wherever the pieces fell, they became the mountains of Africa. "Now you are ready," Todu said. "Your name is Throw Mountains. Let us go find Only One." They went out of the bush country to the place where his father's herd pastured. The cows were greatly surprised. Then Only One came. "I am Only One," the old bull said. "Who are you?" "I am Throw Mountains," the young bull said, "and you are not the only one anymore." Only One became angry, and he put his head down and pawed the ground. Then Throw Mountains put his head down and pawed the ground. They pawed so much earth they made a sandstorm that blew down to the coast and out to sea. They put their horns together and began to struggle. They trampled down a place 100 miles wide where nothing will grow anymore because they packed the earth so hard. Their breath came so hot that the palm trees wilted. They separated and then came together with such a crash that people thought cannons were shooting somewhere. Only One spread his legs and tossed with his great horns, and Throw Mountains went flying into the air. He fell with a thump, and the place he landed became the deep hollow near Batuta. Throw Mountains got to his feet and shook himself. The two bulls rushed together again, and this time Throw Mountains threw Only One with a powerful toss of his thick neck. Twisting and turning, the old bull passed before the face of the setting sun, and the people in the east thought it was an eclipse. When Only One finally came to earth, he fell in the northern mountains, and he flattened them, and it is through this flat country that traders make their way to Kumasi from Timbuktu. Throw Mountains became the chief of the herd, and there was no more killing of bull calves when they were born. And so it is that now sometimes, before a storm, all the old cattle run and buck and jump like calves. This is because, like far-off thunder, they hear the distant bellowing of the great bull, Only One.